Cybersecurity is becoming a real concern this election cycle after a number of reports of voting systems being hacked, leaving some worried that voters longing for the security of paper ballots. According to Verified Voting, an estimated 90 million Americans, roughly 71% of all voters, are expected to use paper ballots this November, but some counties rely entirely on technology, and that leaves them vulnerable. Take a look. The green counties use paper. The yellow ones use electronic voting, but they also have backup that can be double-checked if necessary. The red counties, those are the ones to watch. They are entirely electronic and are prime targets for hackers. Pamela Smith is the president of Verified Voting, which compiled this data. How likely do you think it is, though, when you show those ones in red that are all electronic, that they could get hacked? Because we're not talking about systems that are connected to the internet, even though they are electronic.
That's right. Thanks for having me on. So the thing about the red counties and jurisdictions that you're seeing there, we think that every voter has the right to be able to check that their vote was captured the way that they intended. And election officials can use those records to be able to determine that votes were counted correctly. If you have an all-electronic system and you don't have that backup paper trail that voters can check or a physical ballot that they're marking, that's the concern. It makes it so that when you try and do a recount, you really can only just run the totals again.
But it seems like there is an argument for taking a lot of the humans out of it, so to speak. I mean, I took my son to vote with me recently, and we went in, they couldn't find my name, they handed me a paper ballot, I marked it. When I handed it back, she turned around and tossed it into an open cardboard box. You know, I just looked at it and I was like, there is no way anyone is ever going to count that vote. And I'm trying to put on a brave face for my 9-year-old son. But it seems like a lot of the error that we witness is human error, and this would be better, no?
Well, there are procedural errors like that that don't have anything to do with the technology, and things can go wrong in that regard. Also, it's important to know that humans are the ones that do programming in the technology, so they can make mistakes there too. The ideal thing about having that physical ballot as a backup is that you can count electronically, get a speedy total, but then you can also use those paper ballots to make sure that the total is actually correct.
It is amazing to me when we look at that map that votes are collected so differently across the country, because it seems like if it's a national election, you would think that for fairness sake, everybody should sort of be voting the same way. Why is it like this?
Well, traditionally, elections have been run at the local jurisdiction level, whether it's a county, a township, a parish. Those are all local jurisdictions, and they're usually the ones that get to decide what's the best kind of voting system for their local area. Dealing with voters in a big jurisdiction like Los Angeles County with 5 million voters is very different from dealing with voters in a rural county where there's maybe only 1,000 voters. And so needs might be different. The main thing, though, is that should there be a baseline beneath which all jurisdictions won't sink, you know, to make sure that there's verifiability and recountability for everyone.
You know, we have a map showing in the Southeast and the Midwest, which really has the highest concentration of vulnerable states. You can see it there. Mm-hmm. I have to say, you know, back to my own anecdotal experience, again, I was down in Florida for the last presidential election. There was someone who was a voting captain, you know, for an area, and he said, I'm bringing in my results, and I'm going to tell you my district is voting for this candidate no matter what, wink, wink. And he may have been taunting me because I was a reporter there. But it's still, you know, again, it sort of calls into question the humans that are involved. In the electronic system, is it then kind of locked from a district and added to the rest of the state? Or is it, you know, does it go back to the humans again after that?
From each local jurisdiction, each precinct within the county, say, they do a local total. And usually they'll print out the total tapes at that time. And you can see how many voters voted for your candidate in your precinct. Those totals then get taken to the county and they all get aggregated together there. And from each county, they get reported to the state level. So that's how we end up hearing about the results on election night. They're aggregated at some local jurisdiction level. You know, when you think about the human element, Los Angeles County is recruiting 22,000 poll workers for their county alone for this election.
Wow.
There's really a huge number of people that participate. almost as volunteers, and I would say by and large they care very much for making sure our democracy works the way it's supposed to.
Pamela Smith, thank you so much. Very interesting stuff. Important. Thank you.
My pleasure.
Thank you. Serious new allegations.